Welcome back to the program, guys. Due to social distancing, I will be handling the interview, or should I say a girl's chat, with your homegirl, Katrina. Katrina is aka Boss Babe, aka Fire Chef, in the ex-Big Brother Niger housemates of lockdown season 2020. Katrina is a badass, and I'm happy that I actually get to interview you.
Thank you.
So I hope you're okay and comfortable.
Can we get into the interview? Yeah, very comfortable with my coffee. Yeah.
All right. Okay. So a lot of people actually want to know more about you before Big Brother Africa, because you were one of the contestants that while you were in the house, you opened up a lot. So it talks about your marriage and everything like that. Yeah. Can you describe a difference between the Katrina that we didn't see in the house and the Katrina that we saw in the house?
Going into the Big Brother's house, I wanted to be a different person. You know, I started life at a very young age. You know, all my life I have been very like bossy, conscious of myself, my environment, people I let in, you know. So going on the show, I just wanted to maybe start all over again, like making new friends and being nice and being sweet. But after the 2 weeks isolation, getting into the house, all the whole ideas and plans just flew out the window. Yeah. So being in the house, I was myself. Everything you guys saw in Big Brother's house is who I
am. So all the altercations that you kind of had, those heated moments, those things were not new for you, do you think? Or do you think that the house and the setting and the people brought out that aspect more than normal?
No, I wouldn't say that. Getting to the house, like, I have never in my life been with 20 people with 20 people in the house before. So getting to the house, I was just myself. I love to cook, and the housemates didn't really give me all the support I needed to actually take care of them and be a mom to them. You know, I'll cook, they'll eat and just leave the plate. They won't clean, you know. They were all just being too comfortable in Big Brother's house. So,
but you got comfortable around Lucy. So I mean, I think for us viewers, we were waiting for something else other than love. There was a lot of love going on, so people sort of enjoyed your relationship with Lucy. It looked like the girls were sort of having each other's backs, but at the same time it felt like you guys were excluding yourselves. Did that have anything to do with the age difference, or just like the way the housemates had perceived you both?
Not at all. I'm not sure. You know, the viewers have their ideas, course, and we're in the house, and we know how these things are happening. The first week, I was super excited. If you watched my first diary section, I loved the whole housemate. Everything was so sweet. And then the second week, everyone started bringing up this clique in the house, two together and all that. So, yeah. And with all the drama going on, I just had to, you know, hush a little bit and like, okay, let me just try and observe and try to, let me get to know other housemates instead of fighting and shouting at them at every provocation.
Yeah, to be honest, I have to agree with that. A lot of the interviews, sometimes I feel like you guys give maybe PR answers, but that answer you just gave was very honest, because I did see that towards the end. And that's why I think it pained a lot of people that you were leaving. You got into the triangle of Ozo and Nengi, and you called out what you thought was Nengi's strategy, and you were warning Ozo about that. And people loved that you, for the first time, you're not in the news for like a fight or whatever. You're trying to be strategic or whatever. Yeah. Why did you decide to go? You could have just minded your business and just ignored it. But why did you go ahead and tell Ozo about Nengi? And what is it about Nengi that you saw that didn't just itch you well?
Because Dorothy is my girl and she was in the picture. And I felt, you know, she wasn't coming up to say I am into Ozo, but I'm older than her, and I just felt, okay, this girl is actually into Ozo, but because Ozo already came out and said I'm attracted to Nengi, she just wants Ozo to actually say, I'm interested in you and all that. So I wanted Ozo to do the right thing by choosing Dorothy over Nengi, because I didn't believe they had a future outside Big Brother's house.
I'm with you on that one. Okay, so speaking of connections, you did have a connection with Praise. A lot of the questions I've been seeing about the details, and your response is kind of like all the other housemates, even in the past, that have been in your situation, where, like you mentioned, the viewers have a different idea of what we're watching, and you also have a different idea from you to Kaffee, if you watched last year's performance. Do you now, in hindsight, seeing what has happened on social media, what's happening in you, even with your interviews, Would you take anything from that and do something different and maybe not even get into that situation so you don't have to explain? Because now it looks like what we saw and what you experienced are very different.
Like I have been saying this, I've been repeating myself
over and over
again. Mm. I'm just tired of it. Praise and I connected very first night in Big Brother's house. The house was cold. All the housemates was freezing. We didn't even have our shower. Like, we all went to bed, and everyone went to bed with someone, you know. It was cold. Praise invited me into his bed, and we cuddled together. Praise, like other housemates, is just my friend. Nothing happened. Praise is a dancer. He danced a lot. He always wind his waist. And we're just having a moment under the duvet. Nothing happened. There was no...
No, I know. Yeah. I've seen you explain that. What I'm asking is that... Okay, let me give you an example. Same thing happened with Kaffi and her man, who is now her fiancé. Yeah. And in the same thing, when she came out, she explained that, guys, nothing happened. But we can swear to you with the social media panelists that the leg was going this way, the hands were going this way. So if you, now that this has happened, and every interview, of course, it would come up, would you do things differently and just avoid that altogether, or there's nothing to regret and you really don't mind the heat?
There is no regret, because what the viewers or what people are saying is totally different from what happened. So I am out from the house and I'm just gonna dwell on the love and move on.
I like that. Okay, speaking of your fans, you do have fans despite the odds, despite the fact that the housemates kind of, like, you know, executed you out. What do you think that the housemates saw that the fans saw that the housemates didn't see, and that you were the one to get evicted?
I was a threat in the house. Right. I was loud. They called me bossy. Mm. They felt I had my life going. That I didn't deserve to be there. Like, but that's their opinion, you know. And I feel so proud that they felt I was a threat in the house and got me evicted.
Okay, moving on. Something light, because before you joined in, we played a few games with Lulu. So we're going to do the same with you.
Okay.
If I gave you the power, the ultimate power, you had the chance to evict two people out of the house right now and then also crown someone the winner of the 85 million, who would those people be?
I'm out from the house and I'm moving on. I really, really want to evict anybody, but let's just say it's a game.
It's a game.
I would say Kaisha, because she's weird. And who else? Watoni, she's too quiet.
Right. And who would you crown the winner of lockdown season? Who do you think is deserving?
I can't do that one because I have like three people in that house.
Okay, tell me your three. You have to give me some names.
Okay, Prince, Neil, Dorothy.
Okay, I like those answers. Okay, and then another game before I let you go. You had to kiss someone, marry someone, and then shoot someone. Who would you do? I mean, honest answer. We don't lie on this table.
I have to kiss. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Marry?
Mm-hmm.
And shoot someone?
Yeah.
Not kill.
No,
shoot.
No. So it's basically survive the blow, yeah.
Yeah, okay. I'll kiss Ozar.
Okay.
I'll marry Prince.
Okay.
And I'll shoot. Who will I shoot? Tricky team for being a gossip.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much, Katrina, for having me. Let's say for you coming and joining me on the table today. It was so fun. We'll catch up after the show.
All right. Thank you very much.
All righty. And that's how we wrap up the episode of Tea Time today. Thank you for watching. Join the conversation on social media with the hashtag Tea Time, or tweet at us at +TVAfrica. Remember, you can catch us on this episode and all our exclusive content by subscribing to our YouTube channel at +TVAfrica. You can also watch Tea Time on RTTV and in London on Ben Television. My thank you, as always, will go to Ife, who did the first half of the show today, and the entire production team. Thank you for watching Tea Time on +TVAfrica. My name is Ife Omai. Do stay safe.